Hi, I'm Adam.
And I'm Caitlin.
Today we're going to be talking about some of the more intermediate functions of the adaptive controller for players who may need some additional customization support. In this video, we're going to talk about quite a few different functionalities that can be enabled using the Xbox Accessories app, including things like shift mode, unmapping buttons, and mapping buttons to various actions like raising your TV volume or opening accessibility settings like narrator or color filters, as well as some alternative ways to set up your controller that allows you to control character movement using only buttons and no joystick.
Intermediate and advanced topics.
So first, let's start with shift mode. Shift mode is a function in the Xbox accessory app that essentially allows you to take a single button and give it two different functions. You might use shift mode if you only have one or two buttons within reach or that you can access, but you have more functions in the game that you need to perform than the number of physical buttons that you actually have. So what shift mode does is you have your default assignment for the button. So in this example, this will be A. You can take another button, let's use this B button, and assign it as your shift button. So I'm going to go into the accessories app, create a new profile, take my B button, and click to use it as my shift button. Then I'll go back to my A button, which is A by default, but in its shifted mode, I might want it to be anything else, let's say X in this example, and assign it to X. So what this essentially does is now this button acts as A by default, but when I'm holding down my shift button, this button now acts as X. And you can do this with as many buttons as you want. So if you have two physical buttons and a shift button, you're essentially getting four functions out of just those three physical buttons.
Then there's unmapping. So unmapping is when you take a port function and you basically delete its mapping so that the button no longer does anything.
So maybe you're just using switch buttons that are on the table and you're accidentally hitting some of these buttons on the controller itself, but you're not wanting to. You don't want to use physical interaction with the controller. You can unmap these buttons.
You can go into the remapping interface and choose the button that you are accidentally pressing and just unmap it. So let's say I want to do that for the B button. I'm going to highlight B. I'm going to go into its options. And then under primary, I'm going to go into the menu. And way at the bottom, there is an unmapped option. And now it says primary unmapped. When you press B to back out, you see that the setting has saved, and now you have like a dash indicating that that button is now unmapped.
So let's also talk about something called action remapping. Action remapping is really cool. It's a newer feature. And what it allows you to do is essentially take any button or function, both on the adaptive controller, but also on your standard and elite controllers as well, and actually assign them to different actions with a single press of a button. So here, for example, I'm going to take my view button. And under the primary assignment, instead of looking at the button column with different button assignments, I'm actually going to move over to the action column. And here you'll find a list of a ton of different actions, including accessibility settings, like launching color filters, high contrast mode, et cetera. But there's also a ton of other great ones too, like muting your TV, opening the guide, playing or pausing your media, and more. So essentially, you can remap a single port or a single button to an entire action with just one press. So this is really great if you're constantly or frequently trying to navigate a certain setting or turn something on and off that you're kind of always going back to. You can assign it to an action remapping port.
And then moving from the intermediate settings to something a little bit more advanced, there's a family of settings called sensitivity curves. The sensitivity curves will change how your joystick movements act in-game. Something to keep in mind, though, is that the sensitivity curve experience will vary depending on which third-party external joysticks you're using that are plugged into the adaptive controller. So when you're playing around with this setting, it's important to test out the curve settings with the joysticks you want to use before jumping into a regular play session with the sensitivity curve you're testing out. The sensitivity curves can change how moving a physical stick translates to in-game movement. For example, if I want to change a sensitivity curve from default to instant, what that does is with smaller stick movement, that will translate to immediate large movement in game. So this could be really great for players, for example, who need more in-game movement with using less physical stick movement. This might be able to help players mitigate fatigue by using smaller movements and thus possibly increasing their play session time, for example. As for a deep dive in how to use the sensitivity curves, we have a really detailed support article, so make sure to check that out.
And then the last function that we'll talk about is actually being able to use just physical buttons to emulate joystick movement. So for folks who might not be able to access or want to use a joystick at all, you can remap buttons on the controller to act as basically the same as thumbstick movement of up, down, left, and right. So in order to do this, I'm just gonna go to my remapping UI, click new profile, we'll leave it named as profile 3. And then for the four buttons that I want to be my four directional buttons, I'll just plug them into four ports that I'm not using for something else. So in this case, I just have them all next to each other in A, B, X, and Y. And then what I can do is, let's say I want this A port to be the equivalent of left stick left. I'll just go over to the A port. And then I can remap the primary function as literally left stick left. I could do the same with B. So I'll have that function as left stick right, and then I'll have these two be left stick up and left stick down. And now using just these four buttons, I can essentially move a character, navigate the UI, and a ton of other things using just those four button presses as opposed to moving a full 360 range analog joystick.